The border region in the 1900s saw the accelerated growth of Anglo ranches and farms. Attorneys, land promoters, and developers enticed Anglo newcomers to stake land claims.
The first changes you start to see are that cattle ranching becomes more modern. Anglo-American landowners fence these resources off and put up barbed wire fence, so it becomes harder to be a small-time rancher.
Texas Mexicans made up the bulk of small ranches. Rising land values meant higher property taxes. Frequently, small ranchers were forced to trade land to pay delinquent taxes. Others were dispossessed of their land through title disputes.
Sometimes you would be ranching your own land and not realize that from the point of view of the legal system that it had been sold out from underneath you.
There was fraud on the part of some attorneys. There was intimidation by political leaders. And then there was actual, you know, legal transactions that transferred land away from Mexican hands. People are crossing the border in both directions. Some Mexicans are saying, well, I'm just gonna go, you know, get the steers that belong to mom and dad when they own the ranch. They're perfectly justified. Others on this side are saying, you know, we need to retaliate. People are competing over land ownership. And Mexicans lose out in that fight.
Many Mexican-American farmers and ranchers lost their property, their land, their ranches, because many of them did not speak English. So they couldn't go down and file their title on their property. Somebody else from the outside would come in and says, I file the title, this is my land.
And you also see violence as another way of beginning to take land. A lot of the people they kill were landowners who have disputes with their neighbors over land title, cattle, or over resources like water that are critical to running a ranch.
Once they lost their land through either outright murder and robbery or swindling, or some type of fraud, they then became laborers because they had no other way to make a living.